Hello, hello. Greetings and salutations, one and all. Hey, peace. Welcome to my side of the flip side on a sunny Sunday afternoon in April. Walking around out here, I was inspired to share the vast lushness that I am lucky enough to enjoy in the heart of a big city. Wandering around in a valley that runs below the tower in which I live, and I find myself feeling quite lucky that I'm able to enjoy this despite being surrounded by lots of concrete and cold, hard steel. So here we are in the middle of some trees that have been absorbing much water and light. We've definitely had some heavy rainfalls these last couple of weeks, and seems that the trees have been sucking it all up because the buds are growing quite readily. They look quite healthy. I'm sure they'll be in full bloom before May has hit its midpoint. Yes, the darling buds of May blooming in April. What a sight. It's definitely warm down here. I'm wearing a tank top, although I do have my sweater with me in case the weather turns suddenly and, you know, we get some gusty cold winds blowing by. So far, so good. Can you hear the birds? There's nothing quite like a nice little stroll in nature to clear one's head and get us back into focus, get us back into balance, into equilibrium with our true selves. Work week can definitely take a toll on us, and it's really amazing how just a brief venture into the woods can help reset us back to normal, whatever our normal is, mind you. I love how lush and green the foliage is. It makes me feel full of life once again. I'm just gonna walk around for a little bit and let you see what I see. Get a wider view. And it's great exercise walking in the woods, off the beaten path, allowing our body to move the flow of the land. The inconsistencies inherent in the ups and downs and little hills and valleys contained in the path help us to realign our muscles, the flow of our muscles. Because most of us were stuck in the office for most of the week in a sedentary position, in an unnatural sedentary position, in front of computers, with our backs hunched and so on. Well, that's not how we were intended to be. And so walking around in nature helps to realign our musculature. Right, so while you're out there, instead of just walking on the paved path, my suggestion is step off the paved path. Evenness of nature get you back in sync with what's real. Over there is a pond. People are fishing, which is a little bit strange to me. I mean, it could be sport fishing where they're going to catch and toss the little fishies back in, but you know, that's really cruel to the little fishies. Waters, but people still do it. In here, I've seen many things, from blue herons to turtles to frogs and tadpoles. Well, tadpoles and then frogs, ducks, baby ducklings, geese and baby goslings. Did I say frogs? Yes, frogs. Snakes. Muskrats, beavers. A couple of fishers. I'll continue onwards. Down here I've seen deer off in the woods. One of the coolest things I've ever stumbled upon actually was a deer carcass, which was both sad and exciting at the same time. It was like discovering a dinosaur, or a dinosaur skeleton actually. I was like, this is what it must be like to be an archaeologist who stumbles upon massive bones while on the prowl. So yeah, lots of lovers walk down these lanes, hand in hand, and in step with each other, which is a beautiful sight to see. Through this valley runs a river. And this river apparently runs across the entire province. It's part of a gigantic watershed. I like this section of the river because it increases into baby rapids. There's another section up above, well, up ahead, that becomes even more fast and flowy. I'll show you that in a sec. Well, I'll show you that once we get there. The sound and the sight of this section is quite calming to me, actually. So let's pause for a second and take it in. Amazing. You can sit here for just hours, well maybe an hour, and let the sound take you away to places before, uncharted. It's a great meditation. And I suggest you try it if ever you get the chance. The other things I really love is allowing my eyes to get lost in the sparkles that shine when the water and light meet. See how pretty this looks? The green, the sunlight, the water. Beautiful. Here we have another set of rapids. And I particularly love how this looks and sounds. It's the best of all worlds, I think. You can close your eyes. And get lost in the sound and let it take you away. Wherever it goes. On the other side, there's a huge hill. Something I'd like to hike when the land gets a bit more dry. It's kind of muddy right now. Here's something else I enjoy, which is the way the sun is reflecting just close to the river's bank. You see it? It's quite beautiful as well. This part of the river is somewhat quiet, also nice. Swim. Just up ahead, right here, is yet another one of my favorite parts of this river. So as you can hear, the water becomes more rushy. It's rushing to get on over to the other side and creates, in its hurry, some more rapids. I love how it goes from being calm and serene to looking like a baby whirlpool. Does it crashes over the bend. Let's see if we can get a little bit closer, shall we? Look at how amazing that is. It's like a wellspring of magical sparkles. Let's continue, shall we? Gotta make sure my book doesn't fall. The interplay of light and shadow is also most magical. As you can fully see, I'm sure. Thank you. we come to another bend in the river, where the energy is once again different. It's a different kind of calm. To me, this is more visual. I enjoy letting my eyes drift with the rippling waves, allowing myself to be swept away. Continue on yet again. Have another section of the river, teeming with life. Not sure if you can see it, but there's a cardinal. Up above, freight trains run through a valley, yet the end industrialness of it is nicely camouflaged by this urban wilderness. So it really doesn't seem out of place. There's another part of the valley that looks very enchanted to me. And as we head off the beaten path once again, the energy and the air definitely seems to shift. Amazing, really, that these things exist in the midst of brick houses and luxury condominiums. Serenity like this is priceless, in my opinion. Sides of this bridge. As I collect my thoughts and energies in preparation for the hill ahead. One last bend in the river. It's a little bit more shady now. It's oh so calming. Turn, we shall begin the ascent of the gigantic hill ahead. So let's go. There's a porcupine tree. Darling buds. Condo to the sky. Thank you. does to your legs and glutes. It's phenomenal. There's the river. There's the hill. There's the valley. And there's me saying thank you once again for tuning in. Peace out. We'll catch you again soon. Thanks, guys. Bye.